we had a very lively discussion, actually, not least due to the fact that, for example, the use of CCTV in public areas was one that was very specific, that's very specifically addressed in the GDPR. And obviously, that's something that the security function owns almost by default. So even if as a security function you decided to completely put your head in the sand when it comes to customer data and say this is owned by IT and consent is owned by marketing and communications, you at the very minimum you're responsible for making sure that your CCTV operations are in compliance with GDPR. So that was something that really triggered discussion. I mean, one of the things that I would say organizations definitely need to do is you need to get an overview over what, how you comply with specific parts of GDPR. And I mean, that's a fairly chunky legal document, that's 200 pages or something. So you need to decide which, how you're responding to that, and how you're responding to the very specific requirements in a way that you don't have to make it up as you go along. I mean, I give you a practical example. There is a legal requirement to notify regulatory and supervisory authorities in case of a data breach within 72 hours. That is 72 hours, come weekend, come holiday, come whatever. How are you making sure that your notification to goes through the various internal channels, gets all the right sign-offs and approvals, even if the problem surfaces on a Friday afternoon or on a long holiday weekend? It's not something that's impossible to do, but it's certainly something that's impossible to get right if you don't plan for it.